Hello friends, in this lecture we will learn how to use the helix feature and how to create threads on any part. Now first of all we will start with helix. Now to insert the helix profile, go to the option of menu, insert, go to curves and you can see helix. Now for this helix click on this. Now inside this helix, if we go to the part, we have along vector and along spine. So along spine means we can select with respect to a curve. So right now I'm selecting along vector. Inside this along vector, first of all, okay, let's reset this to have a better understanding. And then we need to select a coordinate system. Now by default, it is selecting the default coordinate system. So we can select any coordinate system with respect to it. After that, we will learn about all these parameters. Now let's zoom in into this and let's see the preview. So with this coordinate system, we can see the helix spring is going upward. Now first thing, it is showing the angle. So we will cover this angle later. We will start with this diameter. Now this diameter means the diameter of the coil. So this diameter, we have some laws like constant, linear, cubic. So I'm taking this as a constant. So it means the diameter is constant throughout the length. So let's say if I change this values. So let's say I select this value 30, press enter. Now we can see the diameter of the turn, coil or turn is increasing. And then we have parameter for the pitch. So pitch is the gap between each turn of the coil. So here we can see in this turns, the distance between this turn and this turn is called the pitch. So let's say I increase this value. So if I increase this value to 10 and press enter, we can have a better preview. Now we can see this gap is increasing. So I zoom out. Now for the length, we have two parameters. We can define the value of length or we can specify the number of turns. So if I specify the limit, it will take the start limit and end limit. And for the number of turns, we can specify the number of turns here. So let's say I specify the number of turns 15, press enter. So these are the number of turns. Now if I zoom in onto this base, so here the coil is created. Now the angle is 0, so let's say this angle is 10 degree, press enter. So here we can see with respect to this coordinate system, the angle is now 10 degree. So let's increase this value. So let's say this time this is 20. So here we can see this angle is increasing, so that is called this angle. Now if I go to the settings, in the settings we have two types of direction. In the helix or any threads, we have two direction, right-handed and left-handed. So right now these are all the right-handed. It means the threads are starting from the right hand. So if I select the left-handed, now we can see threads are starting from the left hand. I can click OK. So in this way, I have created the helix thread. The next option is how to create the threads inside a part. Now to create the threads, what I do is I delete this helix, right click and delete it. And then I go to this extrude and I select this XY plane, select this plane. Now onto this plane, select circle and draw a circle of diameter, let's say this is 30, and press enter. Now finish the sketch and give it some height. So let's say this height is 75 and click OK. Now onto this cylindrical feature, I want to create the threads. Now to create the threads, I have to go to this option of more. Go to this more and you can see the threads. So I can click on this thread. Also, we can find the thread inside this design feature and thread. Also, if I go to this menu, insert, design feature, and here we can see the thread. Select this thread. Now we have two types of thread, symbolic and detailed. Symbolic means whenever we want to create a thread for drill. So right now I want to create the thread for a bolt. So for this we need to select the detailed. Now for this detailed we need to select the face. The threads are created onto this outer face. So I select this outer face. We know the major diameter, so it will automatically take the diameter as 30 minus. So we can play with all these values like minor diameter, so length, pitch value and angle. So let's say I'm taking all these values as default. Now we need to select the starting point. So click for the start and let's say I select this face and click OK. Now zoom out and click apply and click cancel. Now we can see threads are created. So once again I zoom in and here we can see the profile of the thread. So this inclination from this, it is called the angle. So if I go to thread once again and go to feature dialog, this angle is specifying that inclination. Again we have right-handed and left-handed, and we can change the value of pitch from here and click OK. So click OK once again. Now what if we want to create the internal threads? So I select these threads, right click and delete them. Now to create the hole, what I can do is I once again go to extrude and then go to edit parameters and then go to sketch once again. Inside this I will create one more circle. Also what we can do is I go to finish, I create the offset feature. So go to offset and select. So I will select the two sided and start is OK and end value is 5 and click OK. So I'm just taking for the reference and then I want to create the internal threads inside this. For this click on this more option and select threads. Now we need to select the internal surface. Select this internal surface and once again it will automatically take the values. So we can play with all these values. Select the starting point. Now for this length, so let's say I want to create this for the length 50, 60. Starting point, let's say I select this face, click OK and click OK once again. And now we can see internal threads has been created. So this time the threads are created up to a distance of 60. So in this way we can create the threads.